back to Latvia. It's round two of the EMX Open Championship. Round one was here at the Latvian round. This weekend it's the round of Riga, but it's all taking place on the same Zeltezert circuit just outside of Kegums. My name's Paul Mayling. Thanks for joining us today for our live broadcast on mxgptv.com, where we will be bringing you EMX Open and EMX 250 Championship races. The weather is good once again, although a little bit more breeze in the air today than there was over the weekend when we were here for the first installment of three. But I don't think it'll matter too much about that. The racing is going to be as fast and as frantic as usual, but look, 6-7 degrees less than it was the other day. That breeze a little bit more significant. Circuit is still just under 1800 meters long. It's still sandy-ish, but it's a hard base underneath, so very, very shallow sand. A little bit stony in places as well. One or two minor tweaks to what we had on the weekend, but the circuit is, this week anyway, going to be run in the same direction and the same layout as it was on the weekend just gone. This is how the circuit looks. That 180 first turn still stands. Down past pit lane, through the left, over a slight crest, and then into a 90 over crest. The 1, 2, 3, and 4 are the sector points. Obviously, sector one starts from the finish line in that dark gray zone. The lighter zone, sector 2, then 3, then 4. So it'll be interesting to see how the lap times fare compared to the times we had the other day. Anyway, Karol Kutsa will go to the line on pole. The Estonian sits second in the championship. Cornelius Tundal, JWR Racing Honda, will go to the line second, ahead of Toms Makuks, the championship leader from Latvia, Kim Savasti, Stefan Ekerold, Mira Sivinen, Carlos Calais, Eugenio Barbalia, Mads Sjoholm, Andero Lusbo, Nathan Dixon, Domantas, Jas Duskas, Greg Smets, Juuso Matikainen, and Thomas Ragadini, and the rest of the guys that have already been out on their sighting lap. Chris Warren in the blue shirt, the FIM official down there, doing a fantastic job of ushering the riders over the monster ramp there, just alongside the start gate. As you can see, we've still got blue skies here over this Zeltezert circuit, here just on the edge of Kegums. We're about an hour or so from the center of Riga, the capital. And that's only because it's not that far away, but it is just a lot of speed restrictions there. Tom Makuks, championship leader, heading into this weekend. Had a good ride over the first leg, 2 wins out of 2. Karol Kutsa, 2 second-place finishes. He's second in the championship. He goes to the line first, though, and was he about a half a second quicker than Thomas Makuks? 4.85. Kim Savasti on the 137 KTM motorsport machine. What can he do? We're hoping to get on the podium if he can. He arrives here 6th place in the championship. There's Stefan Ekerol. He put in a very good charge in the second race. Oh, I think it was the first race, actually, wasn't it, where he came all the way to 3rd. So he'll be hoping for more of the same. The Fly Racing 15-second board up for the first time today, then, for the EMX Open, European Championship Open. 2 strokes and 4 strokes, 250s, 450s, you name it. If you've got it, you can run it. Anyway, Vice board turns to 5. Big deep breath there for the 108 of Stefan Ekerol just before the gate dropped. He looks to cut to the inside. He might come out nice and tight as well. Yeah, he lost too much time there doing that, but still not too badly placed, though. Slight little step up over the brow there today, and also here. So that's just changed a little bit. Looks more of like they've just carved the top of that crest and through this left-hander. This is all the same. And then out towards the finish line jump. The waves have had a tweak, though. You'll see that when we come around in a moment. But leading at the moment is Kim Savasti. as he goes to hit the line now. So the number 485 from Finland leading the way from Cornelius Tundell. Just behind him there, to the outside is Carlos Calais, then Karol Kutsar, Simeo Ubek, Miro Sivinen, Toms Makkups, championship leader in 7. Eugenio Barbalia, 8. Nathan Dixon is 9. Greg Smets, 10. Jussi Matikainen, Stefan Ekerol is 12. Dom Jasduskas of Lithuania is next in 13th place. And we've got Mike Bolling, Simon Staskovic, Thomas Ragadini, Chris Freemans, Damian Wedich, Arnold Schneikers and Maj Shohope. But the 302 of Cornelius Tundell, he ran pretty good in the first race and then just disappeared off the radar over there on Saturday. But he's looking good here on the JWR Racing Honda. There's the tweak to the waves. Double in, double out, the last section. And then through this left, this right-hander here, takes us back over the Monster jump. And then the slight double now, just here. That was just a little single over. So we'll make that chicane just that little bit quicker as they drop back onto the start straight. Going to be an interesting race, this one. Sebasti still leads, though. So the 137 KTM Motorsport rider. 6 overall. On Saturday, 7th and a 5th place. His starts actually went down in the first turn in the first race. Wasn't much better in the second race, but got off to the flyer here, has the former 85cc junior world champion. Cornelius Tundell, though, just behind him, was faster by about 2 or 3 tenths of a second. 56.8, 57.1 for Sevesti. Stepping up, nice little bit of angle on that this time around, and he looks to make a challenge. Lost the front, you saw how the water there that was just sitting on the surface, well, he was not paying too much attention to that. He saw an opportunity, went for it, but almost cost him. The 302 there, Cornelius Tundell. So the JWR Honda, and again there, the front just, watch this here, comes in too hot, trying to turn. Good job there was a bit of a berm there, otherwise he would have been down. In fact, he might have skiffled the pair of them down. Anyway, through the waves, a little bit loose there. Look, straightens up, and then you've got that double or triple if you choose to. Track was re-prepped again ahead of this EMX Open, this European Championship Open round, as you would have expected. And I can imagine they'll leave circuit conditions mostly as they will end up for tomorrow's World Championship action. Carlos Galeas is still in third place. Karol Kutsar fourth. Up to fifth now. Tom Makkups has found his way past Miro Sivinen. Nathan Dixon in seventh. Simeo Ubek was in eighth, but he's been passed by Eugenio Barbalia, who now moves up to eighth. Ubek nine. And Ekerol in tenth. Struggling to move forward is the German, but a move coming on here. Wah! Watch those spokes. On the front wheel, Cornelius. So the Norwegian on the JWR Honda going, oh, around the outside. He slammed the bank, saw that happening. Big chunk already taken out. It wasn't like a perfect circle around the outside there. Oh, again, just making one or two mistakes. Opting for the safety and the security of the huge bank around the outside this time around. Just looking a little bit untidy at the moment, maybe just trying too hard to get his way to the front. Where's Kutsar? He's in fourth, Makkups in fifth place. This was the lunge. Yeah. Didn't even bother Sevesti. So into the wave section again then, in the back, dancing around, and well, he's had a few warnings, hasn't he, in the last couple of laps, Cornelius Tundell, and he throws it away in the wave section, goes down from second place, hands the advantage to, well, half a dozen riders or so. So including the 92 of Matt Cooks and the 147 there in the red boots, the third rider in shot, Miro Sievenen, who's now moved himself up into fifth place. These two coming towards us, though. Kutsa, Makuks in yellow again, like he was in race one on Saturday when he cruised to victory, hoping that the yellow will do him a few more favours today. Goes to the inside of Kutsa. Kutsa railing the outside. And at the moment, it's working fine, isn't it? Well, Sebasti had about three quarters of a second gap over Tundell last time around. Well, as he hits the line now on lap three, he sets the fastest lap of the race at 56.6. Second rider in shot, this was Tundell. Back end lighting up one way, then the other. And then he just ran out of room there, look, hit the bank. So Kip Sebasti now can afford a 5.7 second advantage over Karol Kutsa. Matt Cook's about another second and a half further back in third. Carlos Kalejic is in fourth, Miro Sievenen in fifth, Cornelius Tundell is in sixth place. Nathan Dixon having a good ride in seventh place for PAR Homes RFX Honda, Husqvarna, sorry. Had a bit of bad luck the first round just a few days ago here, did Nathan Dixon. 13th in race one, and I think it was a broken wheel possibly in race two. Bit of a stretch to get over that triple in the middle of the wave section there. So coming into this weekend, Tom Makuks here in yellow, championship leader, doesn't have the red plate on his bike. Probably didn't expect to be leading the championship, so. He's got to dig deep now, though. He's got to go after Karol Kutsa, the Estonian, on the KTM. Had to do that on Saturday. So, no doubt, prepared to do the same again today. Those outside lines are working a treat, aren't they, at the moment? Up into the bank. Four laps complete. Fastest man on track is that guy there in yellow, Tom Makuks. Championship leader by 0.2 seconds, 156.1. Karol Kutsa was at 56.3. Kim Sebasti, who is only 4.3 seconds further up the track now, is at 57.6. And we've got Tundell down again as Greg Smets goes through and Dero Lusbo right there. So that was just after the finish line. Front end. I just tried to barge the other dude out of the way, look. Was that Dixon? Yeah, it was. So rammed it up the inside of Dixon. Dixon just ran off wide. All right, Kutsa. Doubling from the outside, and Matt Cook's going from the inside. Still getting the job done. So 5.5 seconds separated the first three at the end of lap four. We're on lap five, and you can see Sebasti heading back in the opposite direction. Interesting to see if that gap starts to come down. Let's look at the sectors. Sector one, 36.66. For Sebasti, and then for Kutsa and Makuks, 35.7, 35.9. So they're gained there. They're all in the 26s for sector two, but 1 2 tenths quicker. The pursuers. Then a 32.4, 32.3, 32.0 for the top three. So that gap coming down ever so slightly. It was 4.3, it'll probably be 3 point something now as they hit the line. 57.7. 56.001 for Kutsar. Fastest lap of the race and immediately eclipsed by Madcox, who goes a 55.9. So the first time then we've seen the riders into the 55s. And the gap less than 4 seconds between the top three riders of Kim Sebasti, Karol Kutsar and Tom Madcox. Sebasti on the far side. There's another little tweak, a single into a double. Same for everybody. Before, that was an off section, so you had one line to the outside, one to the inside, so you could kind of split lane almost. And they've obviously artificially created that inside here, just to try and mix things up. The gap coming down all the time, though. Sebasti will move up into third if he stays where he is, but if he gets pushed back to third, he'll lose a few points and he'll be on the same points as Stefan Ekerold. Ekerold now up to sixth, incidentally. So we've got Sebasti, Kutsar, Madcox here in yellow. Carlos Gilles having a good ride. Homeboy, Mira Seaman in fifth, Ekerold sixth, Barbalia seven, Dixon eight, Greg Smets nine. And Dara Losbo now up in a tenth. He's just found his way past Cornelius Tundell. So Tundell having a bit of an up and down ride in this first EMX Open race here at Kegums. Don't really need to be a sand expert to get around this place. Very, very firm base underneath. Just a little bit wispy on top. Makes the bumps a lot more edgy than normal. And as we saw from Cornelius Tundell, when he tried to lunge down the inside of Sebasti on the second lap, he can lose the front very easily as well. Railing this outside here, Kutsar and Madcox, as they gain more ground on Sebasti, who's led for the first six laps. Only a matter of time, though, isn't it? Back into the wave section. Bit of a stretch, isn't it, to get in there? Dropping down in the side. Led to believe the changes will be a little bit more significant when we return here for the third round of this championship on Saturday, and of course for MXGP on Sunday. Expect to see changes over on this side of the racetrack. Not going to say too much now because I haven't seen the planned changes, but going to utilize this part of the racetrack in a slightly different way. Well, that inside's starting to look useful now in that tight left. Cook's trying to find a new line now on the right-hand side as well. Still plenty of time to go, though. 10.5 minutes plus two laps. Sebasti still leads, 57.5 for Kutsar. But he was 0.3 slower than Sebasti. And still, Madcox there in yellow. He was the fastest of this trio of riders that time around. He was in the 56s. Stevenson, 20 seconds behind this battle in fourth place. Gilles in fifth, Ekerold sixth, Barbalia, Dixon, Lusbo and Smets hanging on in 10th place. Tomeo Ubak has found himself going by Cornelius Tundell, so he's now up into 11th. Ah, mistake there from Kutsar. Is it costly? Well, it looked like it, but he got the slingshot momentum around the outside and didn't want to triple in there because I think he knew his line was going a little bit more sort of right to the middle. And he could probably hear on previous laps, Tom Magnus going from the inside, felt that maybe they might touch during the mid-flight. Bit of breathing space all of a sudden, and there's the challenge. So Matt Cook's now up into second place. It came from a mistake earlier on that meant that he was under pressure for a couple of corners, and Matt Cook's was able to get better drive coming back onto the start straight. This was the first mistake. Look, Kutsar just went in too high. And then here, just couldn't get turned tight enough coming onto the start straight. Thought he'd covered his bases. Matt Cooks didn't need a second invite. He was on it like a car bonnet. All right. Gap was 2.4 as he hit the line just a moment ago. He's now got clear track. You can see Sevesti ahead of him, the race leader. Nathan Dixon now up in the seventh place. He's edged his way past Barbalia. Just waiting for those to hit the line for the eighth time. Track still relatively flat. Of course, we've got EMX 250 action coming up shortly. And then another open race. The final race of the day will be 250 boys out on track again. Yeah, he's not confident with that, is he, old Kutsar? A little bit further down here, Carlos Gilles, fifth, Ekerol, sixth. Having their own battle, looks like Ekerol has got the wind in his sails again. Oh, this was the situation I was on about a lap ago between Matt Cooks and Kutsar. Both of those guys jumped, and you can see nervous body language in the air, but in the end, the 108 found his way past the 5.11 of Gilles. Now moves himself up into fifth place. So if Ekerol can only work on his start, didn't make a great jump, he was already trailing. I think he thought he was just going to say, you know what, whatever happens, back off, hold a nice tight line. He just backed off a little too early, a little too much. This is it from another angle, into the waves, got the drive around the outside. And then just watch what happens here as they come around the turn. Looked like they were going to jump into each other. They weren't too far apart when they landed. So the big German 108, Stefan Ekerol, then clear track. Takes a look up the road to see where Miro Sivonen is. About 7 seconds further up the track. There he is. Enjoying a nice, comfortable fourth place at the moment, the 147. Has been on the podium a few times in various European Championship competitions. Mostly in 250, though. Got a couple of thirds, a win here and there. Just been unlucky with the odd injury here and there. Never been able to complete seasons, really, apart from 2016 when he was sixth overall in 250, in the year that he could have won it, maybe. The following year, he had to sit out. He ended up 11th overall, despite taking a win in a third. Sometimes when you're just off the grid, it's a little while just to get yourself mentally tuned again. Good to see he's having a consistent ride here. Fifth overall, first round with a tenth and a third. He's going to stay fifth because Ekerol is going to stay ahead of him. but the gap between them is only going to be about 2 or 3 points. They stay like this. Eckerold heading in the opposite direction. 4.5 minutes plus 2 to go. Lap times for these two last time around. Sievenen 2:05, 2:08 for Eckerold. So evenly matched at the moment, Sievenen and Eckerold. Ten laps done then. First five over the line, separated by 39 seconds. Here's your race leader. It's not 2.6 seconds anymore, is it, I don't think, between him and McCooks. McCooks was so dominant just 3-4 days ago when they opened up their series here 5 months after they should have started. Sebastian, though, looks nice and relaxed. Can't afford to switch off too much, though. I think he might just be extending his lead here, you know. Sebasti was 2.6 seconds clear of Tom McCooks at the end of lap 10. This is a lap 11 coming to an end. Oh, and he goes off the track. Just got messed up there, and that is definitely going to play into the hands of McCooks, because it's now about 1.3 seconds, the gap. So he's all of a sudden put himself under pressure. Did all the hard work, got the good start. Came away with a hole shot. Maybe just offsided because of the back marker. Look, and then he hit a soft patch, tipped over the berm, stayed on two wheels, but right before the finish line. So all of a sudden then, oh, look at the line there of McCooks off the side of the jump. Not in the deep ruts. So Sebasti under attack, although he's responded well to his own mistake, it appears. ...140, so left to run. So Sebasti, 1.3 clear at the end of lap 11. Has he been able to distance himself slightly? I think he has. Visually, looks like that. Oh, we've got big wave yellows here. As the rider in the corner there just spins up. So 12 laps complete. 2 minutes, 1:58, sorry, 8 for Kim Sebasti, 1:59, so yeah, 1.7 seconds now. So he is in control, hasn't looked around. Right, as we get to the top of this hill here and turn right, then we have the step down and the single, the pyramid jump with all the ruts. Just watch the line here of McCooks. Same as that back marker ahead of him, look, right off the side of the track and the other side of the marker, actually. Sebasti, front end a little bit high, thought he was doing a little bit Evel Knievel there, jumping those buses, but wow, he got away with that one. Maybe just starting to push too hard, knows the threat is coming from the rider who won both races just 3 days ago. Let's watch this here. comes in, that was all nice. And then something happened here on takeoff, look. He just caught a couple of holes right in the bottom and it upset the balance at the front end. Right, Mackock's in amongst the back markers. You notice they put a little step there as well, just before the rise. Two laps to go this time around. Sebasti has led every one of these 12 laps. He's going to hit the line for the 13th time as a race leader here in this EMX Open class first race. And he has extended his lead, has he? I would expect so. Bit of a time freeze on the screen at the moment. We'll get there eventually. So 13 laps, 1.9, the gap. Oh, he switched it to the inside now. So Tom Mackooks, the two-time winner here, has about a lap and a half in which to do something about Kim Sebasti. And Carol Kutsar closing in as well, just behind this bat marker, look. So no wonder Mackooks was taking a look behind him. Kutsar is right there. It was a 4-second advantage. Kutsar has just been chipping away. 59.9, 58.1 for Mackooks and Kutsar, respectively. Again, another nervous look over the shoulder from the 92. And barring any mistakes, Sebasti's going to walk away with this one because Mackooks under threat. There's Sebasti disappearing out of sight through the first turn. Got to get by the back marker here. Mackooks can't afford to hang around, but Mike Bolling making it difficult for him. Another nervous look, look, from the number 92. Yeah, come on, Mike. You need to be getting out of the way. I mean, yes, but too late. So, heading into the final lap, Kim Sebasti, already over the line, 59.8. He's extended his lead to 4.5 seconds, but it's Tom Mackooks who is on the ropes here a little bit. Good ride this from Kutsar. Looked like he was out in the wilderness a little bit, but he is definitely put himself back into contention. You notice the difference in lines there as well. Kutsar was over on the right. Mackooks already over on the left. Gained a little bit of time, and then all of a sudden Kutsar right there. He might even Kuts across. And he does, neatly, and into second position. Final lap. Pull him a couple of points back in the championship chase as well. Down to 4 points by the time the checkered flag goes out. But here's Sebasti. So far, he's ridden a perfect race. Getting back to winning ways. Haven't seen it for a while in European Championship action. Ridden a few wildcard races here and there, but who knows if he gets these three rounds under his belt. Good to see him challenging for the championship. That's obviously what he would want. There's Kutsar. Here's your race leader through the final turn, 4.85. On the 137 KTM Motorsport, Kim Sebasti wins race one here at the Round of Riga. Kutsar second in the end. just 4.3 seconds further back. And Hoornakoeks, just wonder whether there was a little bit of arm pump in there. Cornelius Tundell, having a bit of a nightmare. Eventually coming home in 18th place after challenging the leaders early on. Miro Sivonen, we wait for him to come through. He had a little bit of luxury, sat there in fourth place. There he is. 48 seconds down in the end. And then Ekerol, just a few seconds further back. Just waiting for the last of the few guys to come in here and complete the race. As we do so, here's Lisa with our winner, Kim Sebasti.
Kim Sebasti, congratulations. Great race for you. You took the whole shot. You led pretty much every lap of that race. Couple mistakes there at the end, put yourself under pressure, but it's great to see you back to winning ways.
Yeah, it was really nice. You know, it's been a long time since I've been doing well in the races, and this year, I'm just really happy to race with this team in Finland, and now in the second moto I got a great start, and I was able to control the race, but then with the Leopards was a little bit tough, and I had a sketchy moment there, but it was still a great race, and now looking forward to the second one.
Good luck for the second race. Thank you.
Thanks.
Kim Sebasti picking up the win nice and comfortably here in race number one. The 137 KTM Motorsport rider pretty much grabbed the whole shot, never looked back, never put himself under pressure either, as those around him who tried to find a way through eventually crumbled to the wayside. But Sebasti, 4.3 seconds a winner here in race one, moved up to third in the championship as well. Take a look at the official confirmation then for now. EMX Open race one. Sebasti wins, picks up the 25 points. Karol Kutsar second. Tom Makuks faded to third in the end, ahead of Miro Sivonen, Stefan Ekerol, and Dero Lusbo. Nathan Dixon, fine seventh place, young man. And Carlos Kalesh, Greg Smets was next, and then Yuso Matikainen, Eugenio Barbalia, Dom Jasduskas, Simeo Ubak, Arnold Schneikers, Federico Tuani, Mats Sjoholm, Simon Staskovic, and Cornelius Tundell, Damien Wodich, and Mike Bolink. Take a look at some of the highlights from that fantastic first race, shall we? Oh, it looks like we've got a bit of a stiff breeze and some rain on the horizon. Joke! Our track crew is doing a fantastic job. Here's what happened. EMX Open race one here, the round of Riga. Kim Sebasti almost took the front going through the first turn, but he managed to hold on long enough to pull the whole shot. Cornelius Tundell went around the outside of everybody here, 3:02, and was quickly into third, and it wasn't long before he was into second and challenging Sebasti for the lead. But he was riding on borrowed time for a little bit as Sivonen was in there in third. Watch this lunge here, had to pull out, but was just being a little bit too aggressive on Sebasti. And then eventually his luck ran out after one or two warning signs. The back went one way, the other, and he just caught the edge of the bank and fell from second. He was down in about six at that point, but then he rammed his way down the inside of Nathan Dixon. Fell, and then I think he fell again later on in the race. The challenge then came from Karol Kutsar and Tom Makuks. But then Makuks got to the inside of Kutsar, couldn't quite execute the pass there, but by the time they got to the end of the Latvian and championship leader was down the inside, and that was second position for the number 92. Stefan Ekerol eventually found his way past the 5:11 of Carlos Calais as he moved to an eventual fifth place. Miro Sievonen was ahead of him, but in the end, the German not able to close in on the Finn. And it was Sievonen who picked up 18 points for fourth place. Final lap, though, Kim Sebasti, or just before the final lap, Kim Sebasti put himself under pressure with that mistake. And then there was another mistake here on the next jump. Almost got out of shape, but was able to keep a cool head. Matt Cox closed in, but wasn't able to capitalise. And in the end, the flag did fall for Kim Sebasti, 137 KTM Motorsport machine. A little bit of prep work going on out on track, and then, of course, we will be back at 1:55, so not too far to wait now. So before then, though, we'll leave you with some of the best moments from that race, and we'll be back shortly. See you then for EMX 250 Race 1. Mm-hmm.